Welcome, everybody, to Never Tell Me the Odds, the Star Wars RPG podcast and stream. Where we play the Star Wars RPG by Fantasy Flight Games. Yes.
Woo!
What?
Normally I say that differently, don't I?
Do you?
With a little more oomph.
Yeah. Like,
I don't even know what we're playing.
Come on. Put your ass into it.
Okay, I'm going to go full ass this time. Hey, everybody, welcome once again to Never Tell Me the Odds, the Star Wars RPG by Fantasy Flight Games.
That's it.
Closer.
The full butt.
We're a group of nerds, comedians, and awesome, generally awesome people, cool people, play through the Star Wars RPG by Fantasy Flight Games. Yes, that was a much better intro.
Yeah. Much better.
Man, it was a long week for me. How's everybody else doing?
Yep.
I'm psyched.
Yep.
Everybody nods, sighs.
Yep. I just had that conversation with my mom, like, hey, Mom, I'm going to go play Star Wars right now because it's a way for me to fight the Empire. It's our resistance. And she's like, all right, I wish I could go play Star Wars right now is what she told me.
Get her in the studio.
Right?
We need an all-mom episode.
Oh.
Just all mom.
Dave's not sure
mom
about
mothers.
That. Did I was DMing that? I'm trying to imagine what that would be like.
Hot mess. With my mom, it would be like, who's that? What's happening?
Yes.
Where'd he come from?
Same.
Why did they get that?
Yeah.
What's happening?
My mom would just look at you and be like, sure, whatever, nerd.
You got a new mom?
Pretty sure my mom would get really into it. She's a Trekkie from way back.
Yeah.
A movie in, a Trekkie, yeah. X-File fan.
My mom doesn't speak good English, so she'd make a really good alien. Just saying.
According to George Lucas, yes.
Yeah.
Can we get a little more weird alien talk to Rob's mom? Oh, no, that's terrible. Okay, well, we just went around and talked about our moms, but who are we? I'm David Krennan. I'm your GM for tonight and basically every night ever on this show. America's GM.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Dubious title nowadays.
Hashtag.
That's true. Self-assigned and also, just unaccredited. But someday, I'll be there. Who else do we have at this table? Let's do a short little intro and let's start with Talene.
Okay. Hi, I'm Talene. I'm here tonight playing Root, a cerebral Ewok who thinks deep thoughts. No!
That's not true.
Not true at all.
Not movies at all.
She's a murder walk.
Okay.
That's my new phrase.
More like a murder walk. So less an Ewok walk and more of an Ewok.
Murder walk.
An Ewok. Yeah.
Yes. It's like a Matlock.
I like murder walk
a
better.
A Matlock?
It just makes me think of Matlock for some reason.
Oh, that makes it not cool.
Like if Root was a lawyer?
The murder walk? Okay, so you're a murder walk, which means
I've got to go back. I have to back off of that. I've been
It's okay. I already took my mulligan for tonight.
No. Yeah, I'm going to start over.
Wait, what's
up? Hi, I'm Talene, and I play Root. She's an Ewok, lost in space.
There we go.
And she's got a pet baby Rancor.
Yes.
Aww. Super cute.
And what else do we know? Yeah, pet baby Rancor, named?
Yerp.
Yerp,
oh,
great.
Yerp.
And this is important, too. I think we should bring this up because it explains a lot about you. You think you're dead?
I think I'm dead. And this whole weird technology world is the test, the journey through the underworld that I must pass through in order to reach Ewok Valhalla. It's going way longer than I thought it would. Not very well. And I'm a YouTube sensation, which wasn't in any of the texts.
HoloNet sensation, yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's absolutely right. Yeah, I wonder if your Ewok is beginning to doubt her faith a little bit?
Definitely. My Ewok is learning to speak common better and has been stuck performing at a casino long enough that she maybe thinks that she's never going to make it or that this is all there is or...
Let's find out. Let's find out in this exciting episode. Let's go to Terry. But before we do, Darth Sci-Fi Trex just... what's that?
T-Rex.
Sci-Fi T-Rex.
Sci-Fi T-Rex.
It's not Sci-Fit Rex? Okay, Sci-Fi T-Rex. Darth Sci-Fi T-Rex just dropped a $5 donation. Thank you so much.
I thank you so much.
Thank you for the donation.
Appreciated.
Yeah, it's a spicy meatball. Uh-huh.
Wait, what happened to Gerd to be a nerd?
Oh, it's much better than a spice and meatball.
At least it's original.
That's what I was missing from the intro, where I go, welcome to the saving throw.
You were so excited about it. That was four weeks ago, so that's the last time I heard it anyways.
Okay, well,
did use it last time.
Yeah, welcome to saving throw. Yeah.
Yes.
Where it's good to be a nerd.
We're going to make the front page
that was painful.
Our cringe.
Yeah, but it's going to catch on. I'm pretty sure it's going to
catch on. Oh, totally.
Okay, so Terry, do you want to talk a little bit about who you are and what your character is?
Sure. Hello, my name is Terry Gamble, and I am back. I'm so excited to be back here with Kaveri. She is a Jedi style lady. Well, not really lady. She's a... from another world, really.
Yeah, she's a Togruta, I think.
Yeah. She's a seeker. And we've decided a long time ago that her, special, do I need to put this here? That we think her binoculars kind of look like a sandwich, a tasty sandwich that she's always seeking, sandwiches. So in my intergalactic travel, I am looking for more sandwiches.
That makes sense.
Are people trying to warn her that that's not a sandwich, and she's just like, all things are possible through the Force.
Exactly. Yeah.
Continues to try and eat an inanimate object.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm pretty sure.
I'm into it.
I've gone around literally the intergalactic universe, you know, eating all kinds of sandwiches.
I like it.
Intergalactic sandwiches.
Yeah. Or maybe I'll start a shop next time. Like, that could be like a thing, right?
We'll get into what your character's obligation is shortly.
Oh, yeah.
That's great. Mm-hmm. Okay, let's crisscross over to Gaurav.
Hi, I'm Gaurav, and I am playing someone different this time. I'm playing Bosley, which is my character from episode 2, from all the people that used to watch, or I guess listen and watch. No, that was listen only.
That's a deep cut, guys.
When we were podcasting this 2015? 2016? No, 2015. That's when I started that.
The world is different since
Holy
then.
Shit. The world is very different. We were just jokingly having a game where Trumpu the Hutt was a thing, and we're like, oh, this is funny. And then it became really not funny.
Yeah, it became really...
Yeah.
Yeah, like almost regrettable.
Real dark.
So, but you're playing... So in that, back going way back then into episode 2, you were playing Bosley.
Yes.
Who was a human, right?
Yes, he's a human engineer mechanic who was one of the principal... mechanics on the Death Star laser.
And, so did you know Mads Mikkelsen?
Yeah, I worked under him.
Okay, awesome.
Ooh, yeah. Wow. That's nice. Did you tell him how big a fan I am?
What's funny is that we did this plot line way before Rogue One.
Yeah.
Where I was like, oh, that'd be cool if I was a scientist that made the Death Star laser. And then that was the exact plot of Rogue One. I was like, what?
Rogue One That's is so stealing cool. from us!
Yeah, it was dope. And also, better twist than theirs. What planet are you from?
I'm from Alderaan, so I destroyed my own planet.
Whoa!
I didn't know they were going to do that. I didn't know.
Wouldn't that be a cool twist if they had put that in there?
Yeah, that's kind of great, actually. Yeah.
So he's very guilt-stricken last time we saw him and, hates the Empire, but also has kind of helped them with their biggest weapons. So.
And we'll catch up on why it's so crazy that you're back in a moment, but I want to get over to Andrew, if I may.
Hi, everybody. I'm Andrew, and I think tonight I will be playing Gippy Bindoo. a Paul Lynde-esque character whose name I can't recall at the moment. But
Sergeant Johnst.
He's no longer with us, right?
No, I guess where we left off last time, he is... alive and kicking, and also wielding a Kusari gama.
That's right, a really cool ninja weapon.
Yeah.
So, we stumbled on a bunch of Gippy clones last time, so perhaps I'll be stepping forward to fill his slimy terry cloth robe once again.
That's absolutely right. So, guys, that brings us right to the moment of destiny. But before I part the veil of reality, first thing I want to do is thank everybody for joining us. Thank you so much. We are all adventurers. We're all on our own quests. We're all looking for that magic ring, right? Or whatever. But tonight, we are in a tavern. Come on in, join us, grab a drink, raise it high, quaff deep. Rest your weary legs.
What was that last part?
Quaff. Quaff deep of your drink.
Okay.
Everybody else drink a lot of your drink.
It's just me?
Take a big gulp.
No? It's just me?
Yeah. Take a big gulp.
Big drink.
Play more D&D.
You gotta know.
Anyway, guys, at home, if you have a drink, raise it up. We'll be drinking here tonight as well, and we just want to say, hail, adventurers.
Hail, adventurers.
Or I want to say that.
Shut up, Dom.
Wow, Dom.
Dom.
With more feeling next time. Gosh.
Left out, Dom.
The other thing is, I just want to remind you guys.
He's so sad.
Dom is our producer, and he is so sad, but cute.
We love him.
We love him.
Don't look at me.
Did he look away?
Don't look at me!
So I also want to say you guys can donate during the stream to influence the outcome of the game. Darth Sci-Fi T-Rex. already did that, and you guys should see a little bit more of that. You can donate to put rerolls into the game. You can donate to activate certain qualities that people have. For example, Gringo's gambling.
Or
Bosley's nothing.
Bosley's veganism.
He might have some dice in his brain.
And then Talene's character Root has some stuff going on. So you guys can donate for that. You can give us rerolls. You can donate triumphs or despairs, which if you've played before, if you've never played before, are the big game-breaking things that pop in to make something really awesome or really crazy, crappy, bad happen. Either one. So do that. Do those things, and it's fun. And you can also back us on Patreon. Try. What about if you enjoy this today, if you enjoy this tonight, or if you've ever enjoyed it, maybe $1 a month? That's not too much, right? Mm-hmm. So find us on Patreon. We're Saving Throw on Patreon. $1 a month. It means so much to us, and it means nothing
to you.
Saving Throw Show. Patreon.com/Saving Throw Show. Okay, and with that, allow me to part the blast doors of reality.
Smoke.
Ooh,
yes, as the smoke billows through into the darkness beyond, we find ourselves pulled into it, pulled deeper into it, beyond this illusion of the material world in which we find ourselves trapped, onward into the real reality, our imaginations, the stuff that matters. Because we are not here at this table. In fact, we're not even in Southern California. We're not even in this galaxy. We're long, long ago in a galaxy far away. Currently in the darkened, damp, and musty-smelling halls of a decrepit science facility floating in the darkness of outer space. There's a starfield all around it. It's listing if we see it from afar. And we can see some internal lights on, some flickering here and there, but overall it has clearly suffered some sort of massive catastrophe in the recent past. A catastrophe which you are currently investigating because you are inside of this science facility. And as you sloshed your way through the fluid-filled hallways, you encountered dead clone after dead clone. Most of them were Kevin Owens. I think we determined last time.
Yes. The wrestler?
Yes.
Yeah.
That was indeed cloned
by the Kaminoans.
The Kaminoans.
Which is an alien race in the Star Wars universe. But also, someone misheard that at the table.
Oh, I get it.
So there's also Kevin Owens.
That's great.
Floating around in the muck.
That's great.
Yeah, kind of this like knee-deep maybe in places. It's kind of a semi-transparent yellowish fluid, which you guys see spilling out of these like amino acid vats. And there's all these like giant glass tubes, right? What else are you gonna clone a person in other than a giant glass tube? Some of them still intact, many of them broken. Fluid flowing out. We just got a follow from Spangea84. Nope.
Spangea84.
Spangear84.
Thanks for following.
Thank you. And thanks for more money from
Darth
Sci-Fi T-Rex.
Ooh, what's that
$20
for?
Uh-oh. That's
bad news.
Something about to happen.
No, Sci-Fi T-Rex is a good dude. He's a good dude.
He's a great dude.
He's a great dude.
Maybe you got some eye rolls coming.
Or dudette. I actually don't know. But regardless, good person. I know that.
Yeah.
This person stumbled upon that my fetish is to be murdered in an RPG game. Yeah. So, thank you for that. I enjoyed it.
He killed Gippy Bindoos last time.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, he killed Gippy Bindoos last time. So that brings us to where you guys currently are now, which is in a deep inside of this facility in kind of a central room. It's maybe 30 feet, 40 feet across, black exposed metal tubes looping in up and down from the ceiling, all sorts of scientific-y apparatuses and things like this. It must have been used in the past as a staging area or a research area. But at the moment, descending from these tubes and wirings, lowering itself down towards the floor, towards where you all stand, illuminated from below by some unmotivated lighting, but it makes you look really cool.
Ooh.
Yeah, real sci-fi.
Ewok.
A spider beast. A mechanical spider beast, an eight-legged, eight-foot-tall creature with a human brain floating in a glass orb slung underneath where its belly would be. And this thing, as it descends with like weird mechanical grace onto the floor, speaks at you through the tinny, amplified voice, artificial voice of the little, I guess, speaker it has built into it. And it sounds like...
Hey. Hey.
Wait, hold on. Let me see if this works.
Hey, how's it going?
What do you think? That works?
Can you hear me?
Not well.
Probably not great, and I'm going to check with Dom on that.
Dom, try that again.
Dom, you want to try that one, yeah.
Can you hear me?
It sounds creepy.
All right, good. I'll take creepy. I like it. Yeah, you guys hear that out. It's a voice and a brain that one of you recognized?
Nope.
No, no one.
Not no one recognized.
Yeah. That's right. I forgot about that big twist. I forgot that no one who was involved in that. It's currently at the table.
Gippy was at the pit.
Yes, but... You, it's true. There was a brief.
They all turn around and go, like, at the sound of the voice, I don't know what.
Right, because Gippy is just a crowd of.
That's right, so maybe not.
The real Gippy who was at the pit, is currently a corpse kind of strewn across, well, I guess what's left of him?
Right.
He was mostly eaten.
I saved the leftovers on the floor where they'd be safe and they would season well.
There okay, so there's a mass of giblets that is like all that's left of the 400-year-old, or 400-pound, 400-plus pound.
Yeah, these big guys, just rub it in. Anyway.
I'm just trying to be accurate.
Okay, fair 80 enough.
80-plus-year-old Mon Calamari diplomat.
Easily, since we're after Return of the Jedi at this point, he was well over the triple digits, I think.
Okay. So when he died by suffering a massive heart attack, and then...
Wait, that's how he died?
Well, then he confused a bomb for a fruit, I think.
What?
And he was trying to shove that into his mouth.
What?
And then someone shot him in the genitals twice.
Twice?
Yeah.
But someone else had mind swapped with him at the time, so they experienced it.
Wow.
Yeah, it was...
Where did his mind go?
Into the pilot.
Like, yeah, back into the pilot.
Okay.
So, yeah, that actually brings us back to the two of you have
collars
clamped around your neck.
Wait, the two of us? No, alone. I'm the only one with a collar.
You alone have
who can I swap with? Myself.
Well, you could.
Oh, no, I'm in a different, my own body.
That's true, it is just you. Well, and then the other two people who are with you,
yes.
Pilot.
Val. Val, yours is your pal.
Valentine, that's right. Mm-hmm. And the bounty hunter, Maharaja, who is there, the Twi'lek bounty hunter.
Gotcha.
Yeah, are both there as well. They look at each other silently. They're about to open their mouths in horror as the spider beast descends down, when the doors, the back of the room, burst open, and here is where the cloned hordes of Gippy Bindoos charge in. The real reason, whatever this catastrophe was, it appears to have been out of control, Gippy cloning.
Got it.
That causes a catastrophe, makes sense.
A dozen? Corpulent, completely naked, coated in a kind of a mucus kind of slime, Gippy Bindoos, forcing their way together, Three Stooge style, through a single doorway. Like arms sticking out underneath other people's armpits and like faces all mashed together, all speaking at once, all like relating extremely long, out of touch stories from the past, but it all merges together into just a screaming gibberish.
Yeah.
So below me is Root, and who else? Because she's not there yet?
Great. That's a good point. So who would you see? So Bosley, as you descend from the ceiling, you would see an Ewok.
Uh-huh. Her,
Rancor is not currently there. Rancor is back in the ship.
He's hurt.
Hurt.
Oh, no. He's hurted.
You're hurt.
You got hurt.
You would see a man who looks and sounds and acts like Paul Lynde.
Captain
Johnson. Hello there, spider creature.
Sergeant Johnson.
What do you do with all those legs?
And so Sergeant Johnst was the handler.
It's too quiet.
Too quiet.
I'm not going to do it.
You can do it with your hand or something?
Wouldn't you like to know?
Yes.
So is a he was your handler assigned to you by the New Republic when you guys, and this all briefly flashes through your mind as you see these Gippies struggling to get in and kill you, when he was assigned to be your handler, because you're hunting down former teammate of yours, Tamaya, a lady who has possibly gone rogue, possibly turned to the dark side in her delusional quest to try and resurrect her dead husband.
Totally.
Ooh.
There's no doubt she is 100% dark side.
Uh-oh.
Grav,
do you know how to open up my my donation page?
Yes,
I should take a look at this.
I think so.
Great. So, these Gippies come.
Can you do it so Grav doesn't see what the donation
Uh-oh.
I won't. Are they donations live?
No.
I'm just going to call Dom over. Hey, everybody, can we get a round of a hand?
A round of a hand?
A round of a hand.
Whoa.
A round of a hand.
For Dom.
Fushiki ball.
Dom.
Say Fushiki ball?
Yeah.
Wow. That's I know what that is. Doing. Yeah. Oof.
Wow.
Last of the past.
Yeah.
Fushiki ball. I'm making a note of that for an episode name.
Do not. Note of Fushiki ball.
Or a character name. That's a great name. Great. So
I am Fushiki ball.
Definitely a Jedi. Okay. Yeah. So Bosley, you probably don't have time to explain who you are or why you're a brain in a spider body as these things burst in on Paul Lynde, your handler from the New Republic, this Ewok who's by herself, two people who are quiet and not making any moves or sounds whatsoever, Maharaja, the bounty hunter, and your pilot, Val. However, I do want to touch base with you, Kaveri.
Yeah.
So for some reason, you're in this abandoned research facility. For some reason, you're still there, even though there was this massive catastrophe, and you have not yet been...
Not been able to find sandwiches yet? What?
I don't know. What you're hanging around for some reason. Possibly, I don't know. Maybe this is a great sandwich making opportunity. Maybe you've never had a clone sandwich. Maybe you've never...
Well, yeah, we wanted to clone the sandwiches I found on the last place.
So wrong place at the wrong time.
Yeah, definitely. I heard this facility would have been great for that, but things have clearly gone wrong.
And you just kind of found yourself wandering in deeper, doing like the hello? Anyone here?
I've got a Monte Cristo here. Like, I really want to just make as many of these as possible.
All right. Oh, is that donation still up?
Yeah.
Oh, we probably, okay. Well.
It's up to you.
Yeah, sorry, I should have addressed that.
Or should you have?
Well, he's not really playing Gippy Bindu at the moment, so it makes it more difficult to do that. Okay.
How can you kill what's you not alive?
What is dead may never die.
Unless you pay money and then we'll do
yeah,
it.
Yeah, then totally. I actually have, we can do a funny bit about that. Yeah.
Okay, interesting. Well, I will certainly apply this at the moment. But Dom, I think we need to take that option off, if you would. And Darth Sci-Fi T-Rex, I will make good on your donation. Because there are no shortage of Gippy Bindoos at the moment.
Oh, jeez.
Okay, so.
What a horror.
I think you come staggering in, for, like a side door open, so all of you guys are just staring dead ahead. 25 feet away from you, there is a doorway that's about 10 feet wide, and a dozen Gippy Bindoos are like momentarily hung up as they try and squirm their way past each other to come into the room. For what reason, you can't possibly imagine, but the musk that is rolling off of their bodies is intense. Side door opens. Kaveri steps through with a sandwich.
This is not what I expected.
As you pan from Ewok, spider brain droid.
Root?
Hey, you got sandwich.
I do. Do you need some? Are you okay?
No, much bigger problems.
Oh God, yeah.
Okay, so
what
we better
smell?
We better roll for initiative. You immediately see the issue. We better roll for initiative.
Wait, are the Gippy Bindoos attacking us?
They seem like they're, yes, they seem like they're willing to attack.
You just let me know. Let me know when I get to drive on these guys. But sure.
Yeah. When you get to drive on them?
Yeah, well, when I'm back in control of Gippies, if I am.
Oh, would you like to? Yes, I didn't even think about that. Yeah, would you like to tell me what it does?
Are we using your dice? Are we using? Is that your dice?
This is table dice.
I think you would parlay.
Oh, this is table dice.
Oh, it's okay. That's fine.
Oh no! At the moment, I think these Gippies have clearly been. Been deprived of breakfast buffet since they were created.
There's no
programming that has gone into them. They've just been created from nothing, and now as blank slates, they've wandered out into the world. And I think there's the two motivations at the heart of Gippy Bindu.
Oh no!
My understanding are eating, oftentimes living creatures. You have that in common with Root. Mm-hmm. And two, mating, oftentimes with.
Unliving creatures?
Yeah, like Root? Creatures?
I'm alive.
So, yeah, just from the looks of them, and also I believe they exude... Yeah, Gippy does nothing if not exude oozes and fluids, is that right?
So, wait, an important question. Are we about to have a fight in which I try to eat Gippy, because I've already had him, he's delicious, and Gippy tries to eat me? Because I'm ready for that fight.
Yeah, let's do it.
A dozen Gippies are trying to eat you.
A dozen Gippies are trying to eat me, and I'm trying to eat them back.
Perfect. And that's just like a gibbering mouther from D&D.
Yes. Except,
yeah, okay, there we go. That's for four people that probably aren't even watching.
I get out a knife and a fork.
You guys are all going to have to get out whatever you can do. Basically, if these things get to you, they're going to pile onto you, Gippy after Gippy.
Oh, lacking, a lot of Gippy.
Lacking all self-control and possibly trying to mate with you to the point where they're ready to eat you. Would be my guess. Is that fair? Is that unfair?
Is that fair?
I think that there's a lot more like wooing and flowers involved in most of Gippy's mating, but okay.
It fine. Is, no, that's true. He's, Gippy is a pro. These Gippies
Gippy's are romantic at heart.
Would you like to share this orphan with me? It was recently murdered.
That's his idea of romance.
You go. You hear one of them say that as they burst into the room.
Covered in eagle gel.
You can see tons more behind them. Val and Maharaja. Maharaj immediately gets up her gun and starts opening fire on them.
Okay, good. There's
one of the
shooting.
Gippy's heads explodes like an overripe cantaloupe with an M80 inside of it. Real practical
appetizer.
Effect, tons of gore. Val is like trying to get away from her, and then Gippies fall on them. They get knocked to the ground, and you see them get dragged into the horde.
Val and Maharaja are down?
Down and dragged into a horde of Gippy Bindoos. Oh my god, we thank you guys so much. So we have another donation from Darth Sci-Fi T-Rex.
Ooh.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah.
This is excellent.
Some things happening.
Told you he's a good person.
Okay.
He's a good person. Yeah.
Or she, I'm sorry.
Oh, Darth Sci-Fi T-Rex, you are great. You said he was a great guy, right?
Or
wait,
woman.
No.
Or yeah. Woman.
Yeah.
He's a great person.
Yeah, yeah.
It's a guy.
He's a guy.
He's great. A great guy.
Sonic's Anime 44 has just donated 500 bits.
Oh, cool!
Thank you.
Sonic's Anime 44.
Thank
nice.
You so much. Better than 400 bits.
Sonic's not enough. Good anime.
Chili dogs.
Woo. Yeah, chili
way
dogs.
Way past cool.
What are we rolling for initiative? What
oh,
is
okay.
It?
You're cool. I would say in this case because you're trying not to lose your mind.
Oh,
so let's
I
get a cool,
cool
check for everybody.
No, no.
Don't you do that for Paul Lynde?
One success.
Yeah, you better do that for Paul Lynde. So Paul Lynde.
Can Paul Lynde die? Because that'd be nice.
Paul Lynde certainly might die. Paul Lynde immediately draws forth his sweet ninja weapon.
Oh, right.
Is, yeah, Chad decided he had a sweet ninja weapon. The Bard 1971 donates
$20. Oh, yeah, the Bard, my boy.
Thank you, the Bard. That's so great.
Singing that song. Mm.
Okay. Yeah, so Paul Lynde draws out his sweet ninja weapon, which is, of course, a length of chain with a weight at one end and a
hook.
A hook at the other.
Yeah.
Which he
it's that guy from Daredevil.
Also lights up, I think. Mm-hmm. Like a raving
he's got happen. LED lights on it.
Yeah, rainbow LED lights that
Riced
can go off.
Up.
Right? I think we established that last time.
For the raving?
Yes.
Yeah, so Paul Lynde is ready. So Paul Lynde is essentially a pro. He is he's not gonna be easy to take down. For his cool, he can go ahead and roll let's call it 3 green.
3 green? Paul Lynde's way cooler than that, but okay.
Okay, okay.
Fair enough.
How cool do you think Paul Lynde is?
I think he's like at least 1 yellow, 2 green, right? Come on.
All right, you're right. He would be trained in being cool.
Yeah, that's right. I've got this thing.
Okay.
I've never used it without getting on E first, but I'm on a natural high.
So everybody roll that up and let me know what you get in terms of just successes. That's all I care about. This is just for initiative.
So for initiative,
damn.
Okay.
You got 3.
Three successes.
3 successes. 2 successes?
1 success.
1 success, 0 success. It's so easy. Paul Lynde moves with ninja-like grace, like the grace of a fawn in spring.
Who is a ninja?
Bounding forwards.
Also
yes, with
a ninja.
With some light ninja training.
I do a lot of space Zumba.
He's going to have to get in close, though.
That's how I like it. All right, so
I need, you come bounding in, the pile of Gippies is already, like, fallen upon Val and Maharaja. You don't even see
are
a sign
are they dead?
Of
oh, we won't even know.
As you get...
They're alive, they just don't have faces anymore. They're eaten off, it's difficult.
Something seems to be off with these Gippies. Yeah, they're not as fully formed as the other Gippies. It seems like they got dropped out of the oven half-baked, as it were, in terms
how
of
can
clones.
You tell that apart from the regular
unfinished clones!
Bam!
Yeah, they're all like much pinker and floppier. I was honestly considering that in order to sell this bit, I'll just describe it, but I was thinking of going to the supermarket, getting 2 boneless, skinless chicken breasts,
yep.
letting
yep.
them thaw out completely, mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. and then dunking them each in Karo syrup.
Okay.
And then just putting on a pair of surgical gloves and then just like mashing them together to give you a sense of what these gippies are like.
Well, that viewership would just go through the roof.
Yeah.
That's horrible.
It would be the wrong kind of viewer.
There's no such thing as the wrong kind of viewer.
That's true.
That's the spirit.
Yes. Anyone who would enjoy that, I'm glad I'm not.
Ain't that right, Sonic's Anime 44?
They're never donating again.
So Sergeant John's played by Paul Lynde.
Yes.
Easily cartwheels forward, his chain flashing around him in a whirling display of death. Even as he closes in, you can see that there seem to be possibly more gippies beyond. There's plenty of facility beyond this. If he's attacking, he gets 2 yellow and 2 green with his ninja weapon.
Check this out. I'm gonna make some calamari.
Against right. What?
Let's see.
Also, don't we need our points?
Just one purple. We do. We need to do a couple things, guys. So.
Ooh.
Yeah. Can we take off our seatbelts now?
Yeah.
Guys, that's right. Excellent point. We need to roll up our destiny points on the table really quick if we can do that. So everybody, grab a force die or share the force die. If it's a dark side point, which Tilling just rolled, added in there, that's a point I can use to make your rolls worse. Go ahead. Go ahead, Sneezy. 2 light side points, that's good for you because you can spend those to make your rolls better.
Those are the only points I see. Where are the other ones?
We don't have any more.
Oh, I've got a ton.
Okay, cool.
2 light side points.
Light side.
Just
4 total.
One dark side point.
So we're at 2 and 4.
2 dark to 4 light?
Uh-huh.
Beautiful. Okay. And every time you spend a dark side point, it flips over into a light side point. If you guys are playing the drinking game along at home, anytime they flip over a dark side point, you have to take a drink. Anytime they roll, let's do it with me. Anytime I roll threat that is not canceled, you have to drink that many drinks. And if a despair comes up, you have to finish your drink.
Gotcha.
Yeah, those are the drinking rolls. Paul Lynde cartwheels forward. You have to roll against 2 purple in this case.
All right, I'm rolling 2 yellow, 2 green, and 2 purple.
Smash.
Wow, okay.
Damn.
So that's straight up 4 successes and 2 advantage.
Ooh.
4 successes, 2 advantage?
Mm-hmm. Great, on my attack.
So these gippies are pretty well jammed into each other, pretty much defenseless. Each success you generate is going to kill one gippy. So can you describe the whirlwind of death as your razor chain flashes around?
Yeah, so I mean, like it's just flashing like at least every color of the rainbow, and just like a giant whirling blade of death. And you just hear Paul Lynde kind of like a little bit as limbs and heads roll until basically you have just like a giant pile of like neatly cleaved torsos that are just jettisoning blood out of every orifice.
Not blood in this case, clone fluid.
Clone fluid.
Ooh. So it's like an aliens essentially. It looks like when you kill when Bishop gets killed.
And he looks at the rest and he's like, it's not what it looks like. I'm not into water sports. And then that's basically it. Yeah.
It's insane. You guys are all stunned to advantage. What would that be?
My advantage?
Throw a boost to somebody?
Yeah, heck yeah. So, who would be most inspired by geysers of clone fluid?
Oh, if it was blood, I would definitely be me.
Yeah.
It's blood-like.
Is it close enough to blood that I'm like...
I mean, it flows through their veins, and it performs the exact same...
Is it delicious on sandwiches, though?
Because that's that might
really
be
the question.
Yeah.
You would have to try it. I don't think anyone's tried that yet. I'll juice it with the clone fluids.
Boost!
It's one of those French dip sandwiches.
Terry's thinking.
Gippy dip.
Au jus.
It's your boost to hand
Gippy
out.
Gippy dip. Au jus.
Oh, okay. Well, fair enough. Then I'll give it to Root for right now. But
Root will take it.
Yes, go for it.
So the bloodlust inspires you. As long as we're giving out boost die, guys, the Bard 1971's donation was to give each player 1 boost die.
All right.
Thank you, Bard.
Okay, so we are going to have to intermingle.
I'm just writing down 1 boost. I'm not gonna hold
that's a great
boost
idea.
Die.
Okay. So everyone make a mental note that you have a boost die, for example. Hooray. Like that one. Great. Cool. We also have Live to Game. Gives 1 reroll to Garaw.
Alright. Thanks, Live to Game. You got an awesome D&D tattoo today.
What?
Yeah, it looks awesome. It's on Twitter. Check it out.
That is awesome. Yeah. Everyone check that out.
I'd like to see that.
I'll retweet it actually.
It's unfortunately got, it's like behind one of those indecent content blocks, but. You know.
It's one of those to.
A little D and D.
Yeah. Oh.
That's actually really clever. Wow. That would be a clever tattoo.
Yeah, it would be.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Let's all conjure that up in our minds.
Four.
I'm good.
Four Gippies fall literally to pieces.
Yes.
Eight remain, and they only seem more freed now that they're like, they're not stumbling over the bodies of the other Gippies.
Just eat the limbs. That
yeah, like, yeah, yeah. Yeah. Some like when fingers and stuff fly into the air, they just snag them and pop them into their mouth.
Yeah. Seems like every Star Wars movie as I've seen.
Yeah.
Kaveri, you're up.
Oh, goodness. All right. Well, I got a blaster, which is pretty dope. So I'm going to go ahead and, like, handle this because I'm freaking out. It's a lot of Gippy in one place, and they smell terrible. And it's kind of, like, making my appetite not great anymore, and I really would like to finish this sandwich.
What is Kaveri wearing?
Oh, I'm wearing a sweet, like, just, like, kind of, like, tank top outfit with okay. some nice, like, cargo-ish pants, I guess.
The baggy spacer pants.
Yeah, I've kind of looked a little Lara Croft, I think, is the idea.
Oh, I was thinking fallen like Sigourney Weaver and Aliens.
Ooh, yeah, yeah.
Practical, take it. But badass.
Totally.
Okay.
Pretty sexy hot. What can I say?
Do you have any sandwiches on you right now?
Oh, I definitely have one. I have this, yeah, I have this little carrying pack.
Carry the sandwich.
It's for my sandwiches. Yeah,
BSB care.
BSB care.
3 months of BSB care.
Yeah, yeah.
You the best.
He the best.
Love BSB care.
Okay, so yes, you do have some sandwiches. Okay, well, the odor of those sandwiches are probably being picked up by these Gippies and their heads.
Oh, no.
Their remaining eight Gippies' heads all swirl. Because I assume they would eat sandwiches before people.
Sure.
It's a toss up.
It's like, debatable, huh?
Well, you also probably, yeah. So maybe they're going to eat you and your sandwiches. It's hard to say.
Like, I'm there with an appetizer in my body. So that's kind of a problem. Yeah,
that's
right?
Your appetizer.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
The other thing is, I kind of glossed over it. You're a Togruta.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Which, if you guys know the Clone Wars cartoon, that's like.
Ahsoka.
Thank you. I always want to call her Ahsoka. Ahsoka, right? Mm-hmm. So they've kind of got like the cool wavy horn things going on with like tiger stripes.
Tiger stripes.
Yeah, mm-hmm. They're pretty badass. They have like usual like face markings.
Mm-hmm.
Cool. All right. Yeah, you guys saw the picture.
Yeah.
Yeah. Sorry.
What?
Hot lady.
So sandwich lady.
Togruta.
Seeker.
Yeah.
You of course feel the force permeating everything.
Yes.
But you also have a big ass blaster rifle.
Yeah, I do.
What do?
I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna take a couple, aim for at least one of these guys, take them out.
Two purple against your, I think it's ranged light or ranged heavy.
All right. So yeah, two purple against three green and one yellow.
Looks good.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Against these guys, oops. Cancel those guys out, fantastic. So we've got
one success
and three advantage.
Amazing, great. Okay, so one success means one kill, basically. So right through the head, heart?
Whatever, what actually would kill a Gippy? What? Because, I mean, they are kind of gelatinous, really, right?
They become gelatinous in
age. I would say it's just the classic, like, head, heart, gonads, like, whatever you want to have.
Definitely gonad.
Testicle is the one way I'd figure to kill a Gippy.
Because it's not how you, anyway.
Okay, yeah.
How we took you out before was a double shot to the gonads.
Pretty much.
They just lose the will to live when they don't have any genitals.
They are.
What's the point? Yeah. I could probably live, but I'm going to die.
That's possibly true. great. So another one goes down.
Yeah, it's out.
Seven Gippies remain.
Oh God, so much Gippy.
I know. And you had two threat, was it?
I had two advantage.
Oh, two advantage. What is your advantage? Do you want to throw a boost to somebody?
Three advantage. Sorry. Yeah, that's right.
There could be a boost.
Sure, I can throw a boost to somebody. Four. Yeah, I'll throw a boost. Who's got to go next?
Me.
Root is next. She already has a boost.
I have a boost.
Okay. Do you need a boost? Everyone's got a boost right now, though, right?
You can
double
table.
Can I double it up?
I'll still double it up for Root.
Do it.
I believe in you.
Root's gonna boost out.
So what is Root doing? What is Root's reaction to this scene? And again, it's this big black metal room, essentially. No external light sources. This has definitely pulled your attention a little bit away from the robot spider beast.
Everything's cool. This is fine.
Who's down there?
I imagine this would be like closer to a vision of hell, if that's what you
get
were.
Get out of my house.
And
I'm not really looking to go to hell.
Lights.
But this is a bad sign.
Lights are flickering in like deeper hallways around you guys. There's no lights in this room, but it's just like the classic like. Lights flickering everywhere. It's almost like a strobe effect. The gippies continue to flail and flop. Flop. Ugh.
Flopping gippies.
Flopping gippies. Ooze.
Floppy gippies. Mm. Well, what I'd like to do is quickly rig up a trap.
Okay.
I've got nets, I've got ropes.
Yes, you always carry your nets and ropes.
Yeah, so what I want to do is I want to tie my ropes real quickly to the spider legs.
Of this spider?
Yeah.
It's happening.
Little Ewok goes running under you. Starts.
I start smashing. I start smashing my legs.
And I use that to create sort of a gippy corral with a net over the top. And once he's in there, then I come on top of him with my stone knife and just like stab until he's dead.
Wait, what? So wait, okay, I'm slightly confused. Okay, so but you'd have to get a gippy also underneath the legs of the spider to
do that.
That's
why I wanted to use the little spider legs. To be like, move forward, spider.
Oh, okay, so you're just setting up the rope and then climbing on top of the spider.
Well, I was just thinking that I needed something to anchor the net, but I don't think I really need anything to anchor the net, right? If I just like net all of them, get on top and just stab.
Of stuff going, oh yeah, that also is pretty straightforward.
Yeah.
There's
also,
I think I described there's like tubing and scientific apparatus kind of hanging from the ceiling.
Sure, if there's
dark
something
science
convenient.
Magic.
Yeah. I think you can crawl
There's always
up.
A chandelier if you need a chandelier.
Yeah.
Right?
Yes.
So if I just want to use some of the scientific stuff, maybe like even like pull one of them down if it's loose enough.
Yeah, a reticulated tube comes down.
Yeah.
Ooh, there you go.
And just like net them and then they're attached to this so they can't get away. Maybe even they like lifts them up.
Netting the gippies and then the other end is connected to the tubes.
Maybe
and then
the
you just send them up into the roof.
And heaviness and bam and now there's gippies hanging in a bag of gippies. Ah. And I just stab.
Well, let's see how effective you do at that. It's a great plan. So we get the little thought bubble coming out of your head.
Yeah.
Seeing that happen. Poof. To reality. So that sounds like a survival check.
Yes. That's what I want everything to be a survival check.
How many gippies are you targeting?
All of the gippies.
So
no,
seven?
Probably like
the remaining seven?
Five gippies.
Okay,
I think my net can't hold all seven.
I'm going to make that a five difficulty, five purple.
Oh, man.
But if you get one success, you're going to hit all five of them.
Oh, I'm on board. Okay.
Oh, we don't flip up.
So I've got three yellow, one green, maybe. Two boost, and five purple.
And I only have two dark side points to
yeah,
use. I better
you only
use
have
one
two.
Right now.
Why did you point that out to him?
We
was
could
trying
have
to point
it out to you.
I'm sorry.
So now it's four purple, one red, three yellow, one green, two boost. But this is like...
I like those odds.
Never tell me the odds. This is so
name
much...
Name of show, name of show.
Roll credits.
There are so many dice in my hand that like they can't move around. They're just like...
Just a solid block of
just
dice.
Just a solid block of
just
dice.
Just heating up as you shake them. Yes!
No!
Despair.
Wait a second, though.
Hold
up.
Still a success.
Despair. Still a success.
Is it?
Yeah.
Well, this is why this game is great.
So,
how are we doing?
There's no failures. Well, I guess this counts as a failure, but two success. Oh gosh.
We just gotta take stuff out.
You may not. Fasten your seatbelts.
Wait, no, those are both the same. Never mind.
Well, you can, the thrill
you can
of the game.
Them. You can just change this to a success. Take this out.
Okay.
Change this to just a success. Change this to one threat.
I trust you, Groff.
So that's two threat, four successes, and a despair.
Four successes. Yeah, but that's
The despair cancels one out. Thank
Sorry.
You. Okay, right. So two threat, three successes, and a despair.
Okay.
I'm so glad.
Well,
I
totally net five gippies and stab them with my knife. That clearly happened.
Five of these seven gippies are stabbed brutally.
Oh, I love despair it. Is. I know what this is.
If you spoke the language, you would hear the name of his mother over and over again.
Anyway. What was that sound like?
Like that pretty much, like, yeah.
And you're just stabbing, and as you stab, the clone juice is just spilling out of them like a shower flowing down upon you.
Matting up my fur. I prefer blood, but you know. Any vital fluids that can matter.
You
my
can
shirt.
Imagine hard enough and pretend it's blood. It's not so great. It's cold. It's cool to the touch, though.
It tastes vaguely of tartar sauce.
That's why they're so delicious to eat.
Yeah.
You say horseradish.
Okay, your threat is you definitely take. Is it two threat? You take two strain. No question.
I take that two strain, but now I feel like I know what's going to happen with this despair, and I'm ready for it.
Oh, God. Well, yeah, but I know what it is, too. But what were you thinking about?
I'm not going to tell you. Now it's a trap.
But everyone else wants to hear it, right? Okay. Well, then mine is, as you finish stabbing it, and then you put your arms akimbo going, yes. Then you hear the fraying of your rope.
Oh,
and then,
yeah.
A metric ton of sliced...
sliced and diced gippies.
Fish, yeah. It comes...
That was what I was thinking.
Oh, great. Okay, so you are pinned beneath...
Gippies are going to fall on me.
You are pinned beneath a massive pile of bleeding fish guts, essentially.
And Europe's nowhere to be found.
Neurons are still firing, so some of the heads are just going. Focus on firepower, 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 firepower. God bless you. It's really terrifying.
It's a racial memory of all of all mon cows.
Yeah. They all say that at some point.
Well, go ahead, roll two. Oh, I have my D100s over here. Roll this 2D10 to determine how bad the crit is that you take you are crushed.
This is my second critical wound.
So add 10.
So if it's your second, you add 10 to it.
66 or 76?
76. So take an additional critical wound. So those of you following at home, if it ever gets to like 130, you just die. It kills you, but until
it's
you get there.
Kill me.
So you could add 20 to your next roll. I'm going to go off chart. I'm going to go off chart.
Are you?
I think we're going to wing it, because the chart is just a little too silly sometimes.
Yeah.
I love it, though. So 76, you're crushed beneath these fish guts. Oh, man. Face just mashed into the ground.
Should my face be matched? Can my face be? Can I be face up?
Ew.
Yes. Choke. Okay. So I think you're choking on a
no,
Bindoo arm.
No, because this is how I'm going to eat my way out. I'm going to eat my way out.
Stronger than ever.
Like a super shredder moment.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So let's do. Okay. I think just strain damage from your is you're being crushed beneath this weight. So I think you're going to take as long as you're underneath this pile. I'm going to keep dealing strain damage to you.
Okay.
You're basically, you can't breathe, you're struggling to breathe, you're almost drowning
but
in fluids.
But I am eating, also, as fast as I can.
Okay. We'll get back to that.